Our children are watching. They're watching what we do. They're watching what we say, and they're watching how we act. We need to say publicly to every LGBTQI plus person in this country that it is okay to be you. And it's the right thing for you to stand up for your dignity and your freedom. Now, how do we respond to this in the medical community? We need to speak as a medical community and express as clearly as possible about our compassion and about the non-discriminatory provision of medical care.
Is Fred a she or a he?
I don't know. They're just afraid.
Everything okay, Fred?
Oh, the last time I saw my grandma, I used a different name and pronouns. Now grandma doesn't know I've changed. She still thinks I'm her granddaughter instead of her grand... Fred.
I need to tell you.
Really?
But it's time to start.
I know, but this can't wait any longer. If I'm going to lead the herd, I want to do it as myself.
After all, you always say to lead with your heart, right? Well, my heart says that the way I feel most myself is to go by the name Fred. That's because I'm non-binary, and Fred is the name that fits me best. And I also use they and them, because calling me a she or a he doesn't feel right to me.
Oh, I didn't know that. No wonder you've been struggling. How could you lead the herd without being yourself? Oh, I'm sorry I used the wrong name and pronouns.
Hi, I'm Nadine, a sex educator.
And I'm Eva, a sex researcher.
I use the pronouns she and her because I'm a woman, and when I was your age, I used to be a girl.
Gender is how you feel on the inside about whether you're a boy or a girl, a man or a woman. If you're non-binary, feel like neither or both. People can also be fluid, feel more like female, more like male, based on a different day or time. It's really individual.
Absolutely.
Everyone born with a vulva is a girl, true or false.
Or identifies as a girl. Well, not everybody is sure, and that makes sense. But our genitals actually don't determine our gender, so some people born with vulvas can be boys.
These conversations don't have to be limited or restricted to a medical setting. Offer yourselves as informational resources, not just for youth, but for school teachers, principals, school boards, professional organizations, recreation centers, county commissioners, and others who would benefit from this information and your perspective. Please proactively seek opportunities to speak about what you know. Our task is to educate the public in as many forms as possible. And we need to have these conversations that question the assumptions that are underlying today's attacks on trans people. Pushing back the veil of ignorance demands this extra effort. And this is the challenge before our profession.
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man?